Hello students, in last video we discussed about the first chapter of Indian contribution to science, and now in this video we will discuss second chapter, astronomy in India. In this video we discuss about the contribution of India and Indian scientists in the field of astronomy from ancient to modern period. Let's start. The first astronomical object found in Andaman belonged to first astronomical object that is found in Andaman is belong to Paleolithic era, and it is about 12,000 years ago. Next, the first astronomical object or related to a calendar. These are the calendar sticks noting waxing and waning of the moon. Waxing means increasing and waning means decreasing of the moon. So this astronomical object is related to the waxing and waning of the moon, and it is assumed that this is the first astronomical object of India. Next, patterns of rock art found in Kashmir, such as a double sun or concentric circles, depicts. This is the second found object that is related to the astronomy. This is the pattern of rock art found in Kashmir, such as a double sun or concentric circles, depicts. It depicts supernova and meteor showers. It is of about 7,000 years old, 7,000 years ago. It is used and found in Kashmir. Next is the ring stones found at Mohenjo-daro, which exhibit rows of small drilled holes indicate sunrise and sunset at different times in the year. This is also a calendrical device, and it is found in Mohenjo-daro. These are the ring stones that indicate the sunrise and sunset. And the perfect east-west alignment of streets where the star cluster can be seen. The star cluster is also known as Pleiades, or in India it is Kritika. Kritika, R dot upon any, this is represents RI. Kritika, called Kritika. Next is the, according to Rig Veda, after that, in Rig Veda, number of days in a year, it is 360 days and divided into 12 equal parts. The first attempt to reconcile the lunar and solar year by addition of 5 years, 5 year group of 5 years is known as Yug ya era. So in Rig Veda, it is also attempt to reconcile the lunar and solar years. Lunar year means that is depend on the moon, and solar year that is depend on sun. Next is the, according to Yajurveda, number of days in a year. In Yajurveda, it is depicted that lunar year is 354 days and solar year is 365 days. And next, in Yajurveda, ईयर वॉज डिवाइडेड इंटू सिक्स ऋतुज, इट ईयर इज डिवाइडेड इंटू सिक्स ऋतुज और सीजन्स ऑफ टू मंथ्स ईच. होल ईयर डिवाइडेड इंटू सिक्स ऋतुज एंड ऑल्सो ईच ऋतु इज डिवाइडेड इंटू टू मंथ्स, दैट इज 12 मंथ. नेक्स्ट, फर्स्ट लिस्ट ऑफ 27 नक्षत्रास और लूनर मेंशंस, 27 नक्षत्र और लूनर मेंशंस आल्सो इट इज कॉल्ड नक्षत्र, गिवन बाय विच वेदा, इट इज डिपेक्टेड फर्स्टली इन यजुर्वेदा. 27 नक्षत्र एंड लूनर मेंशंस. नेक्स्ट, द फर्स्ट एक्सटेंट ऑफ इंडियन साइंटिफिक टेक्स्ट ऑफ एस्ट्रोलॉजी, द फर्स्ट इंडियन बुक ऑफ एस्ट्रोलॉजी दैट इज द वेदांग ज्योतिष, वेदांग ज्योतिष ऑफ लगध. लगध इज ए ऋषि दैट रिटन वेदांग ज्योतिष एंड इट इज रिटन बिटवीन 12th एंड 14th सेंचुरीज. नेक्स्ट इज द लेंथ ऑफ द साइडरियल डे अकॉर्डिंग टू वेदांग ज्योतिष, अकॉर्डिंग टू वेदांग ज्योतिष साइडरियल डे इज 23 hours 56 minutes and 4.6 seconds, बट इट इज द रियल वैल्यू इज द 23 hours 56 minutes 4.091. इट इज अप्रोक्सीमेटली इक्वल, वेरी लेस डिफरेंस इन दीज टू वैल्यूज, हेयर 0.6 हेयर 0.091, दिस इज द करेक्ट वैल्यू एंड दिस इज द वैल्यू गिवन बाय द वेदांग ज्योतिष. नेक्स्ट, सोलिस्टिस दैट इज आयनांत एंड इक्विनॉक्सिस दैट विशु आर डिस्कस्ड इन वेदांग ज्योतिष, आल्सो सोलिस्टिस एंड इक्विनॉक्स डिस्कस्ड इन वेदांग ज्योतिष. इट यूजेस टू इंटरकैलरी लूनर मंथ्स दैट इज अधिक मास टू कैच अप विद द सोलर कैलेंडर. In this Vedanga Jyotish also it is stated that to catch up the lunar and solar calendar, the one month lunar month is added in the solar year. Now next is the yearly historic period, that is 3rd VCE to 1 CE. A peculiar model of two sets of 27 nakshatras, two suns and moons are in which astronomy, that is in Jain astronomy. Jain astronomy depicts a 27 nakshatra set of 27 nakshatras, two sets and two suns and moons. Duration of day of Brahma, that is Kalp, it is known also known as Kalp, day of Brahma, it is of 4.32 billion years. Next, the age of Earth is approximate 4.1 billion years. In later Vedic period, month was divided into two lunar fortnights. In later Vedic period, the month was divided into two lunar fortnights. That is also known as Pach. One light and one dark. The light Pach is known as Shukla Pach and dark part is known as Krishna Pach. And next is the zodiac of 12 signs, and that is also known as Rasi. 12 signs is first recorded in Yavan Jataka. It is important for your exam. Yavan Jataka, it is approximate 269 CE, written in 269 CE. Next is the Siddhantic era. It is approximate 5th century CE. Duration, Siddhantas means principle or conclusion. The first is the chief characteristics of Siddhantic era are, the chief characteristics is use of trigonometric methods and epicyclic model for planetary positions. Next is the author of Aryabhatta. A book of mathematics and astronomy is written by Aryabhatta first. Time is 476 CE in Patna. In Aryabhatta, these things are discussed. In Aryabhatta, these things are discussed. That is, units of time, features of celestial sphere, Earth as a rotation sphere hanging in space produced the table of the planets. Next, explain lunar and solar eclipses. And next is the diameter. It also tell about the diameter of the Earth, that is 1050 yojanas and approximate 14,280 kilometer. It is approximate 12% large from the correct value. One yojana is equal to the height of 8,000, average height of the 8,000 humans, that is approximate 13.6 kilometer. Next is the Surya Siddhant. Surya Siddhant is a fundamental textbook of Indian astronomy written by Barah Mihir in 505 CE. Worth is the 485 CE of Barah Mihir. Earliest known exponent of Aryabhatta first is the Bhaskara first. Bhaskara first study the book of Aryabhatta and tells more easy way about this book. Next is the Brahmasphut Siddhant. It is very important book written by Brahmagupta, born in 598 CE in Mount Abu. And some instruments are discussed in Brahmagupta Siddhant, that is water clock. It is also known as Ghatiyant, and gnomon is discussed in this book, Brahma Sutra Siddhant, written by Brahmagupta. Ghati. In ghati, one ghati is equal to 24 minute. 24 minute. Who used the instruments suggested by Brahmagupta? There are so many instruments suggested by the Brahmagupta, and these instruments are later used by Lalla in 8th century. Next, who translated text by Barah Mihir and Brahmagupta? That is the text of Barah Mihir and Brahmagupta translated into Arabic and Persian by Alvarni. Alvarni come to India with the Muhammad Ghazni, and he is very influenced by the text of Barah Mihir and Brahmagupta and convert it into the Arabic and Persian. Book of Bhaskaracharya, that is Bhaskara second, also known as, it is Siddhant Siromani, very important. And this book is divided into four parts. First is Lilavati, Vizganit, and Grahaganit. Last is the Goladhyay. And now we discuss in last about the Kerala School of Astronomy. There are so many mathematicians. First is the Parameshwara, 1362 to 1455. It is the founder of dark system. And next is the Neelkanth Samyaji, 1444 to 1545. And his book is Tantra Sangraha, described inferior planets, that is also known as Buddha, Mercury, Shukra, Venus, Mangal or Kuj, Mars. Brahaspati or Guru, Jupiter, Guru, that is Jupiter, and Sunny, that is Saturn. Next, who has given the heliocentric theory in Europe? Copernicus. Heliocentric means sun as a center and all the planets revolve around the sun. It is given in approximate 1473 to 1553. But before Copernicus, it already discussed in India, that is heliocentric theory. Who brought astrolabe to India? Muslim. Astrolabe is an instrument that tells about the planets. Jantar Mantar Observatory is built by Savai Jai Singh in 18th century. That is in Delhi, Delhi and Jaipur, Ujjain, Mathura, Varanasi at five places. It tells many events, that is the solar eclipse, lunar eclipse and time. There are so many instruments are situated at Jaipur.